What's the cadence? I just made up one. How the hell will we take that hill? We'll march up and shoot and kill. We won't cry if we die. I don't know any more of it. Yeah, it's like that kind of thing. Like, the best, everyone knows this one. And this is going to be a sing-along. Now, you know what it is. It's like one of these things that, like, you know, the bad people, soldiers, do. Boom, boom. Let's see, how's it go? Oh, we yo. Oh, oh. Oh, we yo. Yo, oh. Oh, we yo. Whoa. You're not singing along, I know you're not. This is about breaking cadence by Rosa del Duca. Now it's a story, a young woman's story about her tanglings, entanglement, her kind of blunder of being young and vulnerable and getting involved with the military-industrial complex. Now, it's not as though I haven't addressed the military-industrial complex before, so people who have seen like any of my videos know what I feel about that, so here we go. You gotta sing these things with a low voice. Manly. So, and it starts out, heard this book. I consumed it via audiobook because it was just like the easiest way for me to access it. And how did I hear about it? I heard about it because she was on the radio on one of these sort of Pacifica shows that I listened to, which actually fits into what goes on in the story. She is a young, vulnerable, young, vulnerable woman in what, Montana or someplace? And, you know, kind of isolated. And how's she going to get to college? How's she going to do this? How's she going to do that? I think she just has her mother with her, that kind of a family. So she ends up being a victim of the recruiters that go all around. This is in 2001, early 2001, which is critical. So we have the recruiters going around trolling for youth, lying to them to lure them into the military. So you can get an education, you can learn a skill, you can da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. You know, all this line of stuff they give you to sell their quotas of recruitment or however they do it. So she becomes vulnerable to this and signs up at age 17, and her mother has to co-sign for her and goes ahead and does it. But this is the National Guard, and that's part of the whole thing, because, you know, that to get you in the National Guard, they tell you, like, you're just going to fight forest fires, you know, you're going to do stuff like that, you know, or kill students at Kent State. But anyway, that was long ago. Forget about that. So you're going to just be, you know, helping people. Turns out, of course, that really they get prisoners and stuff, you know, cheapo slave labor to fight the forest fires and things like that. So she signs up for this, and it's a 6-year journey when you sign up for the National Guard, and they tell you, you only have to do certain weekends, blah, 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 blah. So what the text of the book, what the story of the book is basically her struggles once she becomes a little more enlightened to, and, well, this is before 9/11, 2001, and the resulting war on terror that went on after that, and I guess still continues in one form or another. So at least it gave the military state and the government a lot of momentum to keep chugging along and, well, basically run imperialist wars here, there, everywhere. Oh, whoa, whoa. And of course, you know, it's not like, you know, we are the good guys all the time because, you know, Putin just sort of attacked Ukraine out of the blue. It's not, it wasn't like there was any provocation. It wasn't like we promised not to move NATO any further east, except that we did it for like, I don't know, 30 more countries or whatever since then, and surrounded his country, and you know, I mean, it's just a load of crap. And we provoked him into it, wouldn't sign a treaty before it happened, and here we are. A budding World War III. You know, maybe I'll be vaporized in this lovely park in New York City, Ground Zero, I would imagine. I kind of want to go in the first blast. That would be better than watching it in the aftermaths. Oh, that's not be so gloomy, Steve. At any rate. So, it's a real personal story where she tells us, you know, all these things that go on in her life. She also is depressed and, you know, like so many of us, and, you know, a little screwed up. She's a young person, and some of us are still like kind of depressed. And it turns out she's a cutter, which ended up being a part of the story. It goes through, fortunately for Rosa, she's very smart, and she is, you know, educated and can educate herself and is a reader and also is listening to Democracy Now!, Amy Goodman, back in right after the war, 9/11 and the ensuing wars. So, you know, she became educated herself and had the had the wherewithal to fight her way out of getting shipped off to one of these wars with various maneuverings that are you know, that she could do. At some point she signs up for our ROTC. And that kind of shifts the whole thing around. So now she's in ROTC, which is, you know, officer training in colleges, so she's getting the education, but she's signed away to go to ROTC. So I'm not going to go through the whole story here of what happens. She's still alive, and I want to link to her YouTube site, which I guess can connect you to her if you want to, because she's, you know, an activist and is helping others who are youth susceptible to these lies of these recruiters of the military state that we live in here, and you know, wants to help others who are not so fortunate as herself to figure out how to get around it. She had help too with activist attorneys and you know, that sort of thing, which is essential in getting the knowledge and working everything around and trying to deal with this. Does she go into active duty? I'm not gonna say. You can, that'd be a spoiler. You're gonna have to get her book. The audiobook, I listened to it via Apple Books, where I think it was like super cheap, like you know, a couple bucks. And it was well worth it because she's a radio broadcaster and a writer, and so therefore she did a very, very good job in reading her story. So it's a really fine audiobook, and you know, there are all these personal things to the story, her love life, this man, that man, her trying to find love and really trying to attach to some of these men who, you know, were not available for their own reasons with depression, this and that, everything that we are all dealing with constantly in the complex society in which we live. So I think that's really all I want to say, and not wear out your ear with the story of Rosa Del Luca, because I think you should just go and listen to it or read it yourself. And furthermore, I'll just go marching off into the wilderness here. Oh, wee, oh, yo.